Canva has released a new feature called Whiteboards. This is now available for both web and mobile users. Honestly, I was confused at first when I saw this because these days the term whiteboard is more often used in the context of whiteboard animations. Perhaps you might have seen those explainer videos on YouTube here with Doodly or VideoScribe or softwares like that. But that could be just me. But if you think alike, please don't confuse those whiteboard animations with this Canva whiteboards. These are completely different and we'll see what it has to offer in just a minute. So the whiteboards in Canva here meant to provide a playful collaboration among team members in a virtual atmosphere. That's how I see this. So maybe primarily this is targeted more towards multiple users working on something together. Although I also see a lot of stuff that an individual user like you and me here can benefit from. Something like flowcharts, sticky notes, planners, mind maps, solo brainstorming, and so much more.
But I hear you saying these were more or less available within Canva already. So what's new in whiteboards? Well, we are here to find that out. Let's go.
First off, you'll see that it's a broad canvas, which Canva calls as whiteboard page, without any page dimensions restricting the flow of our thoughts. As the name suggests, it's basically a large whiteboard page for us to play with by throwing our ideas in here. Okay, as with any other Canva design, we get a lot of templates to play and get inspired from. Well, at the time of making this video, 60 templates to be precise. So when I searched for these whiteboard templates, I got these. But these could be increasing in the coming days, for sure. Now let's see how this navigation works. Now once you're in whiteboard, you can use your control and then the scroll on your mouse to scroll inside and out to zoom and pan this way. And if you want to go across this, like to pan across the whiteboard canvas, you want to hit on your space bar and drag it this way. And zooming can also be done from here. Let's say you want to customize the preloaded elements. Like Canva has brought us ready to use whiteboard specific elements here available at the outset as soon as we click on this elements tab. The number one favorite for me personally here are the sticky notes. These are so good to see and I would love to use them. The colors are also typical to sticky notes, the usual ones that we use in real world. Then comes the graphics. I guess these were already available under the elements in general, but Canva has just curated them here and then made them available, readily available for us to use within these whiteboard sessions. You can click on the see all to see all the different whiteboard stickers that you can, the whiteboard graphics that you can use as stickers here. And I don't know if you noticed, but Canva also got us these collections. If we scroll down a bit, sometime back, which is extremely useful because these are all theme-based graphics, all available and organized like a folder set. Now let's do a quick demo walkthrough. I'm going to expand this so that and then zoom in a bit to see what we can do with the whiteboard. Okay, let's start here. Let me zoom in using the control option. Okay, if you zoom in further, you can see that there are some good, just like the pinboard that you can see where the real world pinboard. It's lovely. We know that already that the shapes can be changed by clicking on it and then you'll get the toolbar at the top. Okay, this is a locked one. I'm going to click on this one and then unlock it. I mean, you can unlock anything here by clicking on this lock unlock. And once you click on the shape, you can change that shape to anything that you want from here. We already had this feature, but this is now very useful within a whiteboard setting. So you can add shapes like these. Let us scroll and see. We can change the shapes here. Let me make this a triangle. All right. And within this, if you double click, you can add text for sure. And clicking on a shape will also give you these plus icons, something called as a quick flow. So clicking on this plus will let me add another shape of whatever we have chosen. And magically, there's also an arrow which combines both these shapes. And this can go on and on. That way, even if you move the shape around, the link sustains so that we can essentially create a super cool flowchart. Okay, now let's go outside and then get on to the next section. So see that we can, we have seen that we have got sticky notes, great. And we can also add comments to that by clicking on this button and then add a comment to that. So essentially, when you're working with multiple people, this comes really handy. And within Whiteboard, there's also a feature called a timer, which when clicked, will give you a preset timer of 5 minutes, which can again be customized. Let's say I want 10 minutes. Just type 10 here. 00. And then start it. So let's say now you're playing a game of tic-tac-toe or a collaboration for, let's say, 25 minutes on the clock.
Pomodoro.
And then you just want to click on the timer and work with your team members until this time completes the timer. You can reset the timer or add one more minute, however you want it. All right, so that's about the collaboration and then the timer part. You can click on the timer again to get rid of it. Now moving on, I'm using my spacebar, by the way, to move around this canvas. And you can use the control and then scroll together to scroll in and out. Okay, we saw that we got stickers here. So let us say now I want to play around by voting on my pictures. All you want to do is just add it. And that's how you can work with multiple members in collaboration. Speaking of flowcharts, I think I already mentioned that we can create super cool flowcharts here. And here's how we can just simply click on these quick flow to add a new stem. Now let us do an exercise here. I'm going to click on this, click on plus, that adds a flowchart button to say that this flowchart ended. So that's how we can add it. We already saw about adding comments to pictures. So you can just click on this icon to add a comment. But this is more useful if you have more than one member working with you here on the same whiteboard. If you're all alone, creating a flowchart or something just for your own reference, then commenting is not a big deal here for us. Now, speaking of what we cannot do here within the Canva whiteboard is, as much as I wanted and eagerly tried, when I went into the draw section, I got a notification that draw cannot be used in whiteboards because I wanted to do some free flow arrows and lines here between designs. But that's not available at this point in time. Maybe this may change in future, but at present, it's not supported within whiteboards. And so is the style section. Let's say now, for example, I don't want this green set of flowcharts. If I can select these, I cannot click on styles and change these color sets because styles cannot be used in whiteboards. Again, this might change in the future, but at present,
it's not available. Deal with it.
So now let's say that you don't want to download the entire whiteboard set. You might just want a piece of it. Let us say that I just want to download my triangles here. So I want to select that and right click and download selection. So this lets us just download the triangles. And of course, while downloading, it will also suggest you, just as usual, Canva suggests you which would be a preferable format. Do you want to take it as a video, or depending on any other template, it might even suggest you to download as a PNG or a PDF format. Go with the suggested formats. More often than not, that's pretty much the one that you may want.
So that's about the Canva whiteboard. But as a tangent idea, if you're also interested in doing comic strips out of the blue, then I made a video for you. Please check it out. I'm sure you will like it. Check it out. Thanks for watching. Bye. Keep creating. Your success is just around the corner. Bye. So now let's say that you don't want to download the complete white graph